They say a picture is worth a thousand words, or in this case, a thousand screams. Number 16. A Reddit user named SummerSkyRyan takes a photograph at the Brown University in Providence, Rhode Island, that he hasn't been able to get out of his mind. These pale faces lack facial details and appear as rough outlines against the glass. Some of them have worried expressions, which makes sense, considering this building was a hospital during the Revolutionary period. I count 6 faces in total, but some people see less. How many do you see? Number 15. These kids with freakish faces all belong to the Mickey Mouse Club. This was the place to be in the 1930s, but almost 100 years later, seeing this assembly makes me want to grab the heaviest nearby object and protect myself. Their faces lose more and more detail as you move up the rows, until they begin to look like a sea of creepy blank stares. Maybe this looked a little less scary in real life, but if not, then I honestly don't know how they could even stand to look at each other. Number 14. A Reddit user named Panda Illusion goes on a Photoshop subreddit to ask the experts about the still image taken by a family member's trail cam. His parents thought it was possibly an angel, but Panda Illusion thinks it looks way too spooky for that, which I agree. Footprints in the snow lead up to a figure that seems to be missing a head. I guess the whole scenario was freaking him out so much that he hoped it was fake. Not only were the experts unable to prove this picture had been photoshopped, one of them by the name of JTXX brightened the picture and turned up the contrast to find out what it was, and it just raised more questions. Nobody can say what this is, but everyone agrees it looks out of place. I think it looks like a tattered robe practically floating in midair. There's no feet underneath, and no arms coming out as far as I can tell. And with nobody able to verify that it's fake, the paranormal is as good as an explanation as why. Number 13. This photo, taken at midnight by Katrina Pararizo, shows a dark object laying behind her on the floor. When the picture is brightened, you can make out the dark hairline of a girl laying on her side. Her face is blurry though, which could be from the lack of light, or could be a sign that it was a spirit. Katrina swears that she was alone, and that no one was nearby. If she really is telling the truth, then I don't see how this could be anything other than a spirit sliding across the floor from behind. I guess she could have photoshopped the corner of a rug, or a shopping bag on the ground to look like a human head if she really wanted to. But what do you think about this picture? Real or fake? Number 12. This famous cookie company is always adding new ingredients, but I'm pretty sure whole spiders is not supposed to be one of them. The smashed bug does not look photoshopped, because the details only become finer when you enhance the brightness and contrast. With that said, I guess someone could have pressed a bug into their cookie and then blamed the company. There's just not enough evidence to confirm if this is real or fake, and so the rumors continue. Until then, if you are going to eat one of these, I suggest you chew slowly and pay attention to every bite for a crunchy surprise. Number 11. This picture of a worker clearing the overgrown front yard of an abandoned house was allegedly taken by a tourist in Mexico. The entrance to the house on the right looks worn down, like nobody has lived there for years, and yet there's also evidence that somebody has been staying here the entire time. The transparent outline of a child watches the worker with a clenched fist, perhaps displeased that his home is being disturbed by the living. Then again, the placement of this ghost at the very edge of the picture almost seems too perfect. So I think it might have been photoshopped. Number 10. A Reddit user named Angel Destoez says that he was staying in a Savannah, Georgia hotel when he felt a strange and disorienting sensation overtake his room. Instead of leaving this room straight away, which is what I would have done, he for some reason takes a picture and just so happens to catch evidence of the paranormal in the form of this ghost hand reaching out for him in the mirror. I think this picture would have been easy enough to fake if someone else was in the room with him to make a shadow with their hand, but if he was truly by himself like he claims, then there would be no way to reach out at that angle while holding the camera. Number 9. These friends take a picture in Brazil moments before the bridge they are standing on collapses, dropping them to the depths below. You can see they are well above most of the trees when this happens, with nothing but chunks of concrete, railroad, and gravel to break their fall. Plus, they are only wearing shorts and sandals, and the last thing you want is bare skin showing in a situation like this. Luckily, all of them survive, but what kind of quality of life they will lead afterwards has sadly yet to be determined. Number 8. A Reddit user named SlicedUpBeef goes hiking in Hamilton, Ontario, and reaches an overlook called Dundas Peak. He takes a picture of his friend with his phone and it looks normal, but when she takes a picture of him at the same point with her phone, they notice something is not right. Off in the distance, they see a figure watching them. It's wearing a white shirt and black pants and standing with its hands at its sides, which would be weird for someone climbing. Even when zoomed in all the way, the pixelated picture still retains enough clarity to make out its clothes. It's on a sheer drop that, according to SlicedUpBeef, nobody should have been able to stand on. Number 7. A trail cam in North Georgia captures this odd and eerie bug-like creature, who residents claim was emanating a soft glow. My question is whether or not this was simply a small bug, caught up close, or some kind of large insectoid creature, the size of a person. I'd want to say this is just a close-up of a small bug, but since a wide portion of the trees seem to glow behind it, I'm not sure what to believe. Number 6. This is the only known picture of Arnie Sanders, a man who spoke of an eternal battle between the heavens and the underworld. He claimed to see angels battling against evil in the subway, and was sent to Rockland Hospital in New York, where he was never released. His eyes are wide and wild as they gaze into another world, seeing things that are not there, or perhaps things we simply cannot perceive, judging from the double dark circles under his eyes. Whatever it is that torments him must never let him rest. Number 5. There are supposed to be two people in this photo. Do you see the second one? If not, that's too bad because he definitely sees you. The furrowed brow of a stranger peers from beneath the corner of her mattress. It's a creepy scenario, but probably not real because of how small his face looks in proportion to hers. If this picture was real, then his whole head is about the size of her hand, and there doesn't look to be enough space in that corner for a person to hide. Still, this photograph has been freaking people out since 2014, and a satisfying explanation has yet to be found. Number 4. This poor girl grew up in Poland during German conflict, and she has seen a lot, far too much for a child. The innocence in her eyes is gone, replaced with an expression of permanent surprise after a short lifetime full of suffering. The swirling mass of chaotic lines is what she created when asked to draw a picture of her home. It's beyond sad that her sense of safety is so shattered that she cannot even visualize stability even within her own mind. She looks back at you with a haunting stare that's hard to shake. Number 3. This unfriendly local clown stands outside of a house in Waukesha, Wisconsin, in an orange jumpsuit for long periods of time, seemingly for no other reason than to get a reaction out of whoever comes near. And that creepy gnarled tree behind him only makes this picture twice as eerie. You can tell by the doorframe that this picture was taken in the safety of someone's car. The way he slowly turns with his feet firmly planted reminds me of Jason or any other slow-moving slasher. His family says that he poses no real threat, but at the same time they can't get him to stop doing it, even at the behest of police. If I lived in that neighborhood, I wouldn't take my chances and walk past. Number 2. This loose-fitting wig and rubber mask are what Edward Paisnell would wear when going after children and adults alike, up and down throughout the 60s and 70s. The mask itself seems to retain a permanent half-smirk, even with no one wearing it, almost as if it's satisfied after inflicting unspeakable misery upon countless innocent people. Edward would wear this outfit to ambush his targets and take them to the same field always, where he would do unspeakable things. Soon he grew tired of this and became bold enough to enter people's homes, going after everyone inside. He did this after watching them for weeks, obsessing over every detail of their routine to figure out when they were the most weak, vulnerable, and unsuspecting. His outfit was made for more than just inspiring terror. These long nails were sewn into the fabric facing outward so that he couldn't easily be grabbed. He also wore these bracelets with nails for some reason, and also to avoid ever getting handcuffed if the police arrived. Looking at him without the mask and near his family, you'd never expect this father was capable of such horror. Then again, his child's uncertain expression says it all. Before we get to number one, my name is Chills, and if you're curious about what I look like in real life, then go to my Instagram at DylanIsChillinYT and tap that follow button to find out. I recently released the number 15 mixtape, but I don't think you should follow these instructions to check it out. It's a proven fact that generosity makes you a happier person. So if you're generous enough to hit the subscribe button and the bell beside it, then thank you. Also, don't forget I upload a new video here on YouTube every Thursday and Saturday. Number 1. In November of 2007, a person anonymously posted a picture of a girl with this message. He offers to give the exact coordinates of her if anyone can correctly guess what their post will be, which is what is used in place of traditional screen names. After someone correctly guesses their post number, he gives these coordinates. On the same day, CBS puts up a story saying, "Investigators have discovered a student located 50 miles east of El Dorado. The coordinates and the picture both match the thread." And in case you were thinking that someone posted this thread after reading the article, it's actually the other way around. The thread itself was posted at 1 in the afternoon, and the article clearly says that she was discovered about an hour and a half later. You may be among the astute few able to predict these endings, but I'm warning you, it's not going to be easy.